See this sign? Pay attention to this sign. No whining. In literature, what I'm going to help your child to do is to be a careful and attentive reader so that they pick up the details of the text so they can interpret the text. The central literary question is always, why did the author put that there? And that's what we're going to try and figure out.
I can feature that.
Oh, God, that's funny.
My name's Don. I live in Monona, Wisconsin, and I'm a woodworker. And I'm working on a love seat Adirondack chair thing. And what I did was send away to Rockler. I'm not doing an ad for Rockler, but I've got a lot of good patterns. When you get one of their patterns, they send along templates so you can trace on the wood where you should cut. And this is what you get.
Wait, what was that again?
Leo Richardson is the Division II Boys Cross Country Champion in the state of Wisconsin with a brilliant finishing time of 15:47.
How did you react?
How did I react? Yes! Yes and yes! How do you like that?
Are you a little happy?
Oh yeah.
To be a reason anyway.
I just got word that you reached the half century mark, major milestone in life. Let's hope you get the three figures. Now that I'm retired, I wanted to tie off some loose ends and take care of things that have kind of always bothered me. So I'm going to give you the gift that you've always wanted. And here it is. It's an A. And I know you always wanted this, and it always kind of bothered me that, you know, you didn't get one. So now you can say, I got an A from Miss Regina, and you got actual, tangible proof that you got an A. Happy birthday, and I hope you have many more.
Chop, chop, chop.
In Elvis personation.
Happy birthday to you.
They weren't poisonous. My grandfather Joseph. My great uncle John came from Italy to the United States in 1904 as cabinet makers. They brought their craft with them and they passed it on to me. If you want solid wood, handmade, really handmade furniture, then I can do this for you. This is one of the pieces I built. And there are many more. Give me a call. Don Regina.
Good evening. I'm Don Regina. If someone were to ask me which author I would like to hear read his or her work, I would immediately choose Emily Dickinson, reading two of her poems, this being the first one. Because I could not stop for death, he kindly stopped for me. The carriage held but just ourselves and immortality. We slowly drove, he knew no haste, and I had put away my labor and my leisure too, for his civility. We passed the school where children strove at recess in the ring. We passed the fields of gazing grain. We passed the setting sun. Or rather, he passed us. The dews grew quivering and chill, for only gossamer my gown, my tippet only tall. We paused before a house that seemed a swelling of the ground. The roof was scarcely visible, the cornice in the ground. Since then, 'tis centuries, and yet, feels shorter than the day I first surmised the horses' heads were toward eternity. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Don Regina. Yesterday I attempted to recite Gerard Manley Hopkins's poem Spring. I did not do the text justice, so here I will read to you the entire poem. Nothing is so beautiful as spring, when weeds and wheels shoot long and lovely and lush. Thrush's eggs look little, low heavens, and thrush through the echoing timber does so rinse and ring. The ear, it strikes like lightnings to hear him sing. The glassy pear tree leaves and blooms. They brush the descending blue. The blue is all in a rush with richness. The racing lambs too have fair their fling. What is all this juice and all this joy? A strain of the earth's sweet being in Eden garden. Have, get, before it cloy, before it cloud, Christ, Lord, and sour with sinning, innocent mind, mayday in girl and boy, most, O maid's child, thy choice and worthy the winning.
Hello, my name is Don Regina, and for the last 42 years, it has not been my job or my occupation or my work, but my honor and my privilege to teach great literature to diligent, intelligent students like you. If I could say anything to myself 42 years ago, sitting across the desk from Sister Kathleen O'Connell, who hired me, I would say, remember the mission. And the mission in teaching will always be the same. It is to take care of the children. To take care of the children. In my subject area, that meant I had to do two things. I had to teach my students to read perceptively, and I had to get them ready to write at the college level. I would hope that I achieved both of those goals. But I would also tell myself that at times you have to be flexible, that some students are going to need a little more help than others. Of the Dominican values, the one I cherish the most is equity. I would like to think that one of the hallmarks of my career was that I was fair. Fairness to me means you treat all the students in the same way and you don't play favorites. My hope for the school in the coming years is that it would thrive, that it would have as many students, and at the time I arrived, there were about 800 or 900, have as many students as it did when I got there, and be a beacon of academic achievement in the coming years. So let me say best of luck and go Crusaders. Bye for now.
Gina Brothers is alive and well.
Smile.
Thank you.
videotape.
Opinion of what?
Okay, so you're on the third one.
Yeah.